Hello! Fifth Eye Gamer reporting. And it's time for day three. Today we're covering the Qurupeco and Crimson Qurupeco. As you can see, I've reloaded my equipment and changed my loadout. This time we're hitting the deserted island for Siren's song and the flooded forest for Bye Bye Bloom. Oh wait, hang on a sec. There we go. Now that's squared away, let's continue. Oh yeah, I learned one recording. I have a time limit of 18:19. So I'm gonna have to be splitting these videos up. If you're wondering why that happened, well, now you know. Yeah, I'm gonna go with this. We may run into a little guess today. I'd rather not be taking any chances this time. You dig? That said, let's continue. As you may have noticed, I've switched to a fire loadout. The Qurupeco is a fire monster, and both of this particular species are weak to ice, hence the sword. Yeah, this one's where things get freaky. I have to find two of these little bastards and take them down. Hopefully before I get completely wasted by our guests, or before time runs out. That's why I've got the paintballs today. Well, let's get started. No time like the present. In case you're wondering why this place kinda looks like Moga Woods, well, it is. It's just the guild happens to be a little loopy. Not here. Yeah, well, these things flying around, this might take a while. I heard something. Let's check Area 8 just to be safe. That's strange. Oh. contact! It'll take more than that to discourage me! Thanks, Ludroth! Oh yeah, when it sinks, you're gonna wanna do something quick about it. Otherwise, it does something like that. Thank you. mate. Now, if memory serves, the next one pops in at Area 5. Oh, man, I mean 7. Never mind. Yeah, Area 7. Careful, Frank House. Get ugly. There, Cha-Cha. Just what I was afraid of. Thank you. Okay, Peco, where are you headed? From the looks of it, Area 5. Wait, are you 9? Really? Well, Peco, if you want to play it that way. At least now I know Rathian won't pursue you here. Area 5. Peco's out, and I am not going to stay here any longer than I need to. Hello, and goodbye. Could have been worse. This is just Rathian. Could have ran to Joe. Well, that rearms me for Crimson Qurupeco, which attacks with lightning instead. It has a few different tricks of its own, too. Oh yeah, this is definitely ideal. So, let's get this disco party started. Oh, and for the record, this is one of the urgent quests for this rank. So you're gonna want to come prepared. Ah, here we are. Maybe we should take the high ground this time. Target sighted! Good. Oh God, this is exactly what I was not hoping for. It's coming!
Thank you.
on, boys! Slow things down. Oh yeah, I almost forgot to tell you. When a Qurupeco's beak is busted, its calls take longer to perform, and that makes it easier to interrupt them. How? Just as easily as he came. It's okay, Cha-Cha. It's always friendly fire. Where do you think you're going? It's like it's Area 9. Fortunately for us, I know a shortcut. Oh, I guess it's in Area 10. I just pulverized the living hell out of it, so it needs some sleep. Probably to get its strength back up and get its wounds sorted out. Let's greet it right. That's it for today's session. Tomorrow, it's the Purple Ludroth and the Royal Ludroth. Anyway, that's all from here. I at least hope this is as entertaining for you as it was for me. And I look forward to seem wise next time. For now, this is 5th Odd Gamer, signing off.